The Radio Wemo Breakfast.
Well, Bandman Wee are very proud to release a brand new EP this week, and also a party on the way as well. To talk with me more about it is Paul from Man Wee. Good morning, Paul.
Hey, how you doing, brother?
I am all good.
Good.
Now, you guys have been, what have you been up to so far for 2011?
Well, actually, it's been, like you said, we're pretty stoked to have this remix bundle out at the moment. And that's been quite cool because, you know, it happens parallel to us. It was actually a bundle of other people remixing the Man Wee tunes. We've let some other producers dip their hands into the Man Wee archives.
Always nice to sit back and let someone else do the work, eh?
Well, it is, actually. You kind of sit, like, as soon as someone says, hey, here's a new track, you know, when they've finished it, you do get this kind of tingle of, man, I wonder what they've done with it.
It
is very exciting to open up a new mix from some other people and see what they've done with the Man Wee thing.
Now, you guys have been releasing these remixes, though, incrementally, haven't you?
Yeah, we did do it over the summer. We decided to every Monday to put one of these out, and it was just a link up on Facebook where people could, pretty much the first 100 people could grab them for free.
Nice idea.
Yeah, it was kind of fun just because we had these around that were starting to come in, and so we thought, well, this is a good way to get people hearing them, because I kind of feel like remixes are personal taste, you know? That's the whole point of remixes. I see them like a cover. It's like a band doing a cover of another band's song.
Yeah.
And so, you know, a producer takes it and says, all right, I want to tweak this and play this in my DJ set, so it needs to have these elements here, or this needs to happen here and here and here. So really, they're kind of DJ mixes of tracks to be able to fit into different situations. So, of course, that comes down to taste. So I just love the fact that they're able to be out there and people can kind of pick and choose from them.
Now, remixes of Man Wee in 2011 as opposed to, say, 5 years ago probably sound a lot different, don't they? What's the flavour that's coming through?
Well, once again, it really is personal taste. Admittedly, there is a fair bit of dubstep in there.
Yeah.
To be honest.
It's got to be, right?
But that may also have been the people that we asked.
Yeah.
So we kind of did it to ourselves a little bit. But there's 16 tracks, and I think there's kind of something for everyone in there. You know, admittedly, they are DJ tracks. So there's real minimal stuff to kind of quite funky and electro stuff, and there's an Oral Trash mix in there, and as well as Agent Alvin and the Upbeats. And actually, the Upbeats is the one that surprised me the most, I would say.
Yeah.
Because when you hand them a track to remix, you kind of assume what it'll come back like, and it wasn't like that at all. It was completely different.
And plenty of funk and slow cuts in there.
Oh, well, that's true, because funk and slow cuts is Ryan from Man Wee, so he gets the largest opportunity to dip his hand into the, the archives, because it's already on his computer. That's true.
Yeah, and nice to see Simon Flower in there as well. I mean, he's been a long time remixer, producer on the New Zealand music scene, and also overseas as well.
Well, exactly, and it's very much that minimal tip that's big kind of in certain blocks in Europe and things like that. He's signed a lot of stuff over there that, yeah, maybe a lot of New Zealanders wouldn't know his stuff just because it's that different scene, you know.
It
fits into a certain niche. He was telling me, though, that he remixes live. He does it live. He kind of runs it out of, like, some keyboards and some... He has the computer running, and then he just basically presses start and records it all to tape, kind of thing, which is not often how producers do it. They kind of labour over how it'll be, but he said he has this really organic take on it, so it's kind of cool.
Which is nice, because that reflects also what you guys do live as well.
True. Well, Man Wee's an interesting one, isn't it? A lot of people say, well, you're just standing up there pressing play, because I can't see your guitars or
not,
your drums.
Not at all. I've had you guys play, I think, a couple of times here in the Kiwi studio, and there's a lot more that goes into it than that, that's for sure.
Well, that's right. And actually, and we need to communicate as well when we're playing live.
Yes.
I don't know if you've ever seen that. We try and stand in that kind of triangle shape. And one time we tried it in a row, and it was just a complete mess, because the person on the far side didn't know what the other person was doing, and it was just a disaster.
But nice. Sometimes it's a smile and a nod and a wink. Isn't it?
Yeah, and sometimes a nasty look.
What'd you do that for?
It usually comes from Ruth, but that's it.
You're also Organicismus in there as well. K-Lab.
Yeah, K-Lab's a cool one. He's a guy from, he's in Wellington at the moment. I think he was in Black Planet from Queenstown a few years back.
Yeah.
But he's doing some really cool stuff, that real glitch hoppy kind of thing. I'm liking that tune.
And drum and bass heavyweights, the Upbeats.
That's right. Yeah, and that's the one that surprises you.
Is it?
Yeah.
Ooh, okay. Aotearoa is the one they've done. And there seems to be a favourite tune throughout the album, Aotearoa.
Yeah, well, that's quite funny as well, because we often just say, hey, just choose a tune to people. You know, we don't really hand them one.
Yeah.
And often Aotearoa comes up and people kind of chop out the words that they want. I think even Optimus Grime has done one of those mixes, and he's kind of kept it for his own album, so we'll see where that ends up.
Anyone come up to you these days and go, hey, that's that tune from that Sky TV channel?
All the time.
It's a lot more than that, isn't it? It's a lot more than that. And the one thing that Minwe has been doing a lot of lately is getting fans involved, and that's really been the strength for you guys, you know, sort of going forward, is engaging people online,
right,
really, isn't it?
Right.
You know, through those downloads, but also through the Aotearoa video, you know, getting people to send in their photos to be part of the video. Have you got any projects in the future that you can think of where you're going to be getting people involved?
Right. Yeah, those are funny. We don't really plan them. They kind of just happen accidentally.
Ah, okay.
Because you have this at your disposal, don't you? You know, this Facebook thing or this thing called email.
Yeah.
And I don't know, we really like that, because we do get a lot of responses from people often suggesting things themselves about having a, can we please have a mass treasure hunt around New Zealand to try and find something. You know, it's like, actually, that's a really cool idea.
Do it.
Have a scavenger hunt kind of thing.
Do it before someone else does.
Well, exactly. There's so many cool ideas, and it shouldn't always come down to the band, but it's we're lucky to be in a position where we can kind of make something happen with it, you know? And like also having Ruth's book out recently, that's been really interesting as well, because it's quite a different angle to the music thing, but still crosses over a lot. And that's been really interesting, some of the takes of that as well.
I'd imagine, because it's been a little while since the last Fresh album, that you guys are working on something new?
Indeed. What have you heard?
I'm just guessing. I'm throwing it out there. It's about that time, really. Are you guys in the studio?
Right. It's about overdue, actually. That's what it is.
Yeah.
We are, we do have, we've got a couple of weeks actually set aside in July, where we're all getting together in the same place, because we all live in different towns as well. It's kind of a nightmare. So it's like, all right, let's get something down. Ruth's got lots of ideas for new songs, and yeah, there's plenty on the way.
Cool. Well, the EP is called, well, the album really, it's a remix album called Dance Music Will Tear Us Apart Again. Available only online, or also a physical copy as well?
It is actually only online.
Okay.
Yes, just digital. The best place, I reckon, is Bandcamp.
Yeah.
So if you go to minwe.bandcamp.com, I'm really liking there at the moment, because there's our entire catalogue is up there at the moment.
Yeah.
And so you can just, while you're at work, you know, just press play and sip through.
And that's exactly what I'm doing now. I'm on Bandcamp.
Exactly.
This is what you're hearing coming through the radio right now.
Yeah,
is Bandcamp. So you can try it before you buy.
That's right, and it's not just 15 seconds, it's the entire song. So.
And the nice thing to do is when you also buy it, you tweet it out or like it on Facebook as well, just let other people know how cool you are for downloading that music and paying for it.
That's right, they're $1 a track. You don't have to buy the whole thing, you can just buy one if you like. That's right.
Yeah, nice. Hey, Paul, look forward to hearing from you again soon when the new album is nearer, and you've also got a party coming up.
It was last weekend.
Oh, it was last weekend. It's gone.
Yeah.
I missed that. Oh, well.
But it was in Wellington, so it was good.
Oh,
you,
okay.
You wouldn't have been able to be there. It's all good.
All
but
right.
we're in Christchurch in a couple of weeks' time as well. Those who are down in Christchurch, there's a huge Mad Hatter's tea party. I think it's called a Christchurch Stress Relief Event or something.
Oh.
It looks absolutely crazy.
That sounds very cool. All right, look out for that. In the meantime, minwe.bandcamp.com. I will play the Upbeats remix. As you said, it's going to be surprising, so I'm going to be surprised.
Cool.
Thanks, cheers. Paul.
Thank you.
Cheers.
No worries. Cheers.
Salvage what we get, you and me.